Miriam Merad's groundbreaking cancer research has shed new light on the immune system's double agents, macrophages, and their impact on tumours. For this pioneering work, she has been awarded the Sjöberg Prize 2025.
Miriam Merad's research has been instrumental for understanding the myeloid branch of the immune system and how those cells are interacting with cancer.
Miriam Merad's research is important because cancer rates are constantly increasing, and therefore it's urgent to find new cancer therapies.
Miriam Merad grew up in Algiers, the capital of Algeria, in the 1970s. Her parents were both doctors at a local hospital, and Merad often spent time there. Watching their unwavering dedication inspired her decision to pursue a career in medicine. Miriam's academic journey first took her to Paris and later to the United States. In 2004, she arrived at the Icahn School of Medicine at Mount Sinai in New York, where she developed a deep fascination for a relatively unexplored aspect of the immune system, myeloid cells, particularly macrophages. Utilizing advanced methods to trace the origins of cells, she made a groundbreaking discovery. When we develop cancer, our immune system can launch an attack on the tumor. This response involves various types of immune cells, including T cells, which target the tumor directly. But alongside these are macrophages, the body's cleanup crew. Macrophages exist in many organs of the body, but where do they come from? It was previously believed that all macrophages originated from cells in the blood system. However, Miriam Merad now demonstrated that many macrophages are permanently located in the tissues of various organs, such as the brain, lungs, and skin, without being replenished from the blood, where the macrophages are ready to defend the body against threats. Furthermore, she showed that these macrophages are not derived from adult blood, but are generated from distinct cells in the embryo's development.
Miriam Merad's discovery has transformed the understanding of the immune system and explained how specific immune cells are produced.
Miriam Merad's discovery laid the foundation for her continued research. Using single-cell technology, which reveals precisely which genes are active in individual cells, she was able to map many different types of macrophages and their unique characteristics. This led to a breakthrough when she was able to demonstrate how the macrophages that surround a tumor act as double agents. The tumor, surrounded by various types of immune cells, has managed to recruit some macrophages to work on its behalf. Miriam Merad discovered that these macrophages had undergone changes in their gene expression. So, instead of fighting the tumor, they switch sides. They begin to send signals that suppress the immune system's ability to attack the tumor. This particularly affects the T cells, so the macrophages are aiding the tumor's growth.
This insight was groundbreaking because it explains how tumors can exploit the body's own immune system to evade attacks.
It's an eye-opener because now with the knowledge of how macrophages and other myeloid cells signal to other cells that attack the tumor, we can actually pave the way to find new therapies.
Once Miriam Merad had identified these double agent macrophages and the specific signals that suppressed T cells, her goal was to block the signals. This should reinvigorate the T cells and enable them to start attacking the tumor again. Using this new understanding of the various signals from macrophages and other myeloid cells, She hopes to generate a stronger immune response against the tumor. This will provide completely new insights in an exciting and rapidly emerging field in the fight against cancer.
So the initial attempts to affect macrophages in clinical trials have already been conducted by Miriam Merad, and the result looks promising. So we can hope that this will lead to new cancer therapies for various types of cancer.
Miriam Merad is awarded the Sjöberg Prize 2025 for discoveries identifying the origin of myeloid cell subtypes and elucidating how they modulate anti-tumor immunity.
Emotion, a lot of emotion, and honored, you know, always honored when peers respect what we do. So, and there is something special about the Royal Academy of Science Sweden, you know, to us all. So even more honored that it was coming from that extraordinary society. So I had a very good plan for this money. And in fact, it's a very timely gift for us. You see, in science, the ability to take risk is key, right? Take risk, be bold. And this type of prize allows you to be bold, right? So I was saying I would like to try to look at whether we can prevent cancer. That's a crazy thing, right? Can we really prevent cancer to happen? So this gift will now be used to immunoprevention trial in patients that are at risk for cancer and see whether we can prevent cancer, in fact, development in these patients. I'm very excited about the possibility to test that. I was raised in a family where my two parents spent their life, you know, trying to build, you know, academia in a country that had just become independent. And they did it in a very engaged, passionate, joyful manner. This is how they inspired me, is contribute. You need to contribute to society.
The Sjöberg Prize is awarded by the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences and is financed by the Sjöberg Foundation.